Like Black Klansman, black movie.
See, so this is a sad. This is sad for me because it's not, and it hurts me because it's Spike. And so for me to see somebody like Spike come up from all the way
and Jordan Peele. Jordan Peele is the producer.
It's
that.
Based off a book, right? Off the guy, the real life.
The real life.
But just off of what me watching Spike Lee and like it hurts just to know that dang, Spike don't own his stuff by now. Like, and he just getting the Oscar now. Like, all of those things, I feel like. Will open up the doors to this conversation right now about what we're talking about ownership of black film because that was a problem. Like, yeah, Spike Lee won, but then he lost in the other nominee against Green Book, and you know the conversation that they're having about that, you know. So
yeah, what's the conversation?
Well, it's sad that in this day and time where we felt like we've progressed as an American country, that a book about a racial reconciliation fantasy still overpowers the truth about a racial actual historical time and moment.
Right. So hold on. So the Green Book, I thought that's not based on real life.
It's based on real life, but it's a fantasy for white folks watching it. It's a racial reconciliation fantasy. Like, all right. So Driving Miss Daisy was saying we could bring an end to race by having this conversation with this black man, this white woman. Right. And now the Green Book is like, we can end race by having this conversation with the black man, white man, but now the black person pays you to learn how to, you know what I'm saying? To learn learn and be educated on how to, you know, go about addressing or interacting with black people or whatever.
Right. Okay. Yeah, I don't know if we could go back to talk about Spike, because when Spike started, he depleted all the credit cards that he had when he first started. She's Got to Have It and some other films.
You do the right thing.
Right. And you're talking about being filmed on the block he's from. Mm-hmm. So you're talking about the beginnings of him is all black, is distributed, you know, pretty much by him. She's got to have it. And then, you know, when we get to the theatrical releases, of course, he got to go to the big houses to get distribution. Yeah. When he goes for a major theatrical release, he at that time, he has to do that. Yeah. But the beginning of it, if you look at it, if you look at behind the scenes, man, all these cats behind the scenes on 40 Acres and a Mule look like me and you. Yeah. The artistic directors, they were HBCU graduates. They were all those. That was all combined inside of Spike. That was his vision. Yeah. As he's gotten older, he knows I got to dance with the big houses to get it theatrical release because nobody's going to look at it. If you look at Malcolm X in 93 when he released Malcolm X, he had to deal with the big house because you had Denzel who was not on the way, he was already there. Yeah. Because his loyalty to Spike, he plays his character and everybody around it. Of course Spike Lee I think he got snuffed.
Yeah, he didn't get nothing.
I think he got snuffed. Yeah. And I think that was the film he should have been. He should have got the Oscar for, as well as Denzel should have got the Oscar for as well. You know what I'm saying? So you're talking about in 93 where there's a film, black film. That talks about a theatrical world release about Malcolm X, which is heavy. Yeah. It's still 93. We're moving around. You know what I'm saying? We're doing our thing. It's Do the Right Thing situation. It's, you know, we're actually wearing the X hats. It's serious. Yeah, yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And so we're like, oh, man, this has got to do it. And I think Al Pacino won the Oscar that year, if I'm right.
What movie?
Was it Goodfellas? Is that 93?
Al Pacino wasn't in Goodfellas.
No, I'm sorry. Al Pacino won it, so I don't know what it was.
Okay.
Al Pacino won best actor.
It was one of those.
I don't know, but I know he won it that year. Anyway, neither here or there.
Yeah.
We have to go back and say that Spike, that was his vision was to have everything black owned, black financed, and he financed, but I mean, he ate up credit cards to do it.
Yeah.
And I guess I think he, you know, use other folks' money to get where he had to go.
I mean, I don't think.